What electrified me was seeing all of the equipment they have here.
At St. Thomas, we have a fully operational microgrid. You're controlling electricity. You're moving power from one place to the other.
We are kind of on the frontier of this line of research.
The hands-on educational opportunities that you're gonna get here, you won't be able to get in any other place.
At St. Thomas's School of Engineering, the Center for Microgrid Research is one of the only places in the U.S. where undergrads have hands-on experience building the 21st century grid.
Thank you for being here. I think we're building something very unique and very exciting in St. Thomas. And
I'm Mahmoud Kabalan. I'm the director of the Center for Microgrid Research. There are challenges in terms of the aging infrastructure, the changing climate with more severe weather. We're seeing more and more malicious attacks on the grid. A microgrid is a local energy system. It can be as small as a house, and it can be as big as a city neighborhood.
The beauty of a microgrid is you can integrate whatever form of energy you want. Generation could be any traditional form, diesel generator, solar, wind, battery bank. So microgrid just combines them all together in a localized space.
I'd say the core of it is kind of helping our power grid move more towards renewables and helping push the technical space of allowing that to happen in a smooth way.
The microgrid will expand to power part of St. Thomas's campus, including the new Schenecker Center, bringing reliability, resiliency, and a new generation of engineers.
We need engineers with the skill sets right now, and the current labor market is very much demanding them. It puts them so far apart from their peers that they're immediately hired.
Like if it's producing energy, it'll send it out back, and if it's consuming, exactly.
You know, you can learn about a resistor in class and how it impedes the flow of current, and then you come to the microgrid, at least for me, and you see a resistor actually doing what they told you it does. This is PhD level stuff.
For example, we'll say, all right, generator, we want you to run at 50 kilowatts and 480 volts.
I'm mostly working with simulating the microgrid, studying how it behaves in like island mode, which is when we disconnect from the grid and power certain parts of this campus.
Now, with new funding boosts from state and federal government,
we just announced a big partnership with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers.
Companies and institutions developing clean energy can innovate here too.
Ultimately, we will be a one-stop shop research center.
Through prototypes and simulation, the Center for Microgrid Research offers real-time testing for real-world solutions.
Just living unsustainably, we're living dangerously. We need to do better.
Okay, perfect.
Engineers can do more, can drive change, can affect change by dreaming of the world that we should be living in the next 50 to 100 years.
Undergrads navigate a microgrid and their future, realizing the power to change the world is truly at their fingertips.
Tackling one small piece of sustainability in order to make a difference.